competition. I would request Meeta ma'am to take it ahead. I'm on your mute, ma'am.
Namaste, namaste, and good afternoon. I request our RD sir, Mr. Venkateshan, who has just joined us. Mr. Venkateshan, sir?
Yes.
Yes. Sir, request
good evening,
to
everybody.
Please
yes.
Start the program.
Yeah. Namaste and a very good evening to all. And my special thanks to Advan Knowledge Hub for putting together this event today. In fact, a year-long nationwide activities on Constitution Day were launched to mark the 70th anniversary of the adoption of the Indian Constitution by the Constituent Assembly, beginning November 26, 2019. This annual celebrations were launched last. The day 26 November, as we know, is celebrated as every year as Constitution Day and also popularly known as Samvidhan Divas. The activities planned to celebrate the Constitution Day primarily aim to reiterate and reorient the citizens towards the values and principles expressed in the Indian Constitution and encouraging all Indians to play their rightful role in strengthening. In fact, the India Tourism Mumbai has been celebrating this across the Western region. And we chose the theme to promote the fundamental duties. And our campaign was perform your duties, build the nation. In fact, the aim of this Constitution Day is to publicize the glorious and rich composite culture and diversity of our nation. Further, it also aims to create an awareness of the fundamental duties, as I was saying, as enshrined in the Indian Constitution. As citizens of our great nation, we believe firmly in the Gandhian thought that, I quote, the true source of rights is duty. If we all discharge our duties, rights will not be far to seek, unquote. And as also said by Sardar Patel, every Indian should forget that he is a Rajput, a Sikh or a Jat. He must remember that he is an Indian and he has every right in the country, but with certain duties. With this, I request Ms. Smita Galwadi and the quiz team to kind of launch the quiz. And it's truly a very important occasion for us. We would have had it in a physical format, but for the pandemic and many of our events have gone virtual, but this does not dampen our spirit. I know all of you have prepared well and are ready to compete. And I look forward to hearing more and getting more knowledge from all of you here. Thank you, Ms. Gulwadi. You can take it forward.
Thank you, sir. We'd like to now open it to Pritesh, who will be the quiz master for the session.
Hey, good afternoon, guys. I hope everyone is excited for this quiz. Okay, I'm excited because I'm more excited because I know the answer. I have no idea from your end. Do you know the answer? But I hope everyone knows the answer so that we can have a really good fight. Okay, so let me explain you about this quiz. Okay. So first of all, let me share my screen with you. I hope it's visible. Okay,
yes,
I hope the screen is visible. Okay, so the quiz is on the Constituent of India and the citizen's duty. So the quiz is on that, okay. And to be frank enough, every one of us, including myself, including yourself, we have learned all this thing in our civics. So this is nothing new for us. But the only thing is we should really know in our day-to-day life also what are our rights as a citizen of India. Okay. So that is one thing which you would be getting to know. There will be a lot of shocker, I would say, from this question. And I really hope we don't have any tiebreakers because this is one thing which I really don't appreciate, tiebreakers and all this thing. But I know we might have tiebreakers and all this thing. So starting, before we start, I would really like to know the teams, you know, so that's easy to communicate. It's easy to get along. You know, it's going to be like a 1 hour. We need to know each other. So I'm going to start with team one. So I would like to know that your name, what exactly are you doing? Okay. And from which college? Okay. So I'll start with Suraj. So team one, so you can start introducing yourself.
Okay. Good evening, all respected sirs and madam. I am Suraj Nivruti Ghode from Ram Narayan Ruiya College. I'm currently doing travel and tourism management, BVoc degree course from Ruiya College. And currently I'm in second year. And my partner is Archie Bindal. Archie, please introduce.
Hello, everyone. I am Archie Bindal, and I'm pursuing bachelor's in vocational studies, specialized in tourism and travel management from Ram Narayan Ruiya College. Okay. Over to team two.
Okay, no, that's my responsibility. Thanks a lot for that thing. Okay.
Sorry.
No, it's fine. Welcome, team one. Okay. Hope to see a good competition. Okay. So let's go to team two now. Okay. So team two, so Ganesh, can you introduce yourself?
Yes, sir. My name is Ganesh Ajarani. I am currently working with Vina World. And over to Mir Joshi.
From which institute are you from?
The School of Excellence.
The School of Excellence. Okay. Yes. Yeah, Mir. Mir, you are on mute. Mir, you are on mute. You need to unmute yourself. No, Mir, you are on mute. You need to unmute. Unmute yourself.
Yeah. My name is Mihir Joshi. I have done my post-graduation certificate diploma in travel and tourism from BCD Travels. And I am currently doing internship at WOW.
Okay, fine. Thanks a lot. Welcome, team two. Okay, let's go to team three now. So team three, can you introduce yourself?
Good evening, everyone. My name is Shakti Shirke. I'm from Dr. BMM College of Home Science. And I'm doing resource management.
Okay, great. And what about your another partner?
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Mayuri Kenny, and I am from Dr. BMN College of Home Science. And yeah, I am doing the BSc in Human Resource Management.
Okay, great. Welcome, team three. So let's proceed to team four now. So team four, can you introduce yourself, please? Team four, yeah.
Yes, sir. Good evening, everyone. I'm Roshni Thakur, currently studying in SYBCOM with Travel and Tourism from Manibin Nanavati College.
Okay, great.
Hello, everyone. I'm Urja Valodra. Currently, I'm pursuing second year Tours and Travel Management from Manibin Nanavati Women's College.
Okay, welcome, team four. Okay, let's see some good competition. Last but not the least, team five, if you can just introduce yourself.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Keval Fumaria. I'm currently pursuing third year from Bharati Vidyapeeth Institute of Hotel and Tourism Management Studies, Belapur, Nayi Mumbai. And the name of my partner is Shetan Kapadia. Over to her. All the best, everyone.
Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Shetan Kapadia, and I'm currently pursuing third year of Bachelor of Science in Hotel Management from Bharati Vidyapeeth College.
Okay. Welcome, team five. Okay, whenever I see hotel management, it's just a bit soft corner, because myself, I'm a hotel management graduate, so I, you know, always a soft corner towards those people. Okay, so nothing with the quiz. Okay, only soft corner when it comes to, you know, like this. Okay, so now we have five teams. Okay, and we have three rounds, and there would be one special round. I'm going to say it later on. Okay. Let me introduce my team. Okay. So I have the buzzer girl. Okay. So normally I don't say buzzer girl, but she is going to help me with, with the timing. Okay. That's Divya. So Divya, can you show that the buzzer, what we are talking about?
Okay. This is the buzzer. And it looks like this.
Okay. So what does it mean?
Is it audible?
Guys? Yeah. It's totally audible. Okay. Divya. So what does it mean, guys? So each question will have a time limitation. Okay, once it's done, Divya is going to do that bell. Okay, that means it's time up. Okay, so we need to do virtually, right? So things in virtually works like that. Okay, Now, we even have Smita ma'am, Smita Gulwari, Smita ma'am. She is our score master. So she is going to record all the score. And regularly, I'm going to ask her, you know, what are the scores? So we can actually get to know the score also. Now, the most important thing, all your scores, okay, which is from round one till round three, okay, all the score will be added. Okay, so please remember each round is important for you. That's number one. Number two, as we have five teams, so we are going to directly start with semifinals. Only five teams, we're going to directly start with semifinals. So in semifinals, we are going to have two rounds. So the top three teams from the semifinals will go to finals. Is it clear, guys? The top five teams, we have already have top five teams. From top five teams, the top three teams will go to finals. And the score, which is in your semi-final, will be carried forward to final also. Please, do you have any question, any doubt? Please ask me right now. Any question, guys? Any doubt?
So how will we be raising our hands? Like if you
don't ask don't worry about that. That will be explained during the round time.
Okay.
So that's there. Okay. Now, so let's
meet.
Pardon?
Can I?
Yeah. Please go ahead.
We will be having a buzzer time.
So what exactly is going to happen is team three, there will be one question, okay, which will be for you only, and you will get 10 seconds to answer that question. Is it clear? You know the answer, amazing. Yeah. If you don't know the answer, there would be certain, every round will have certain shocking and surprises for you. So every round will have some kind of package deal for you guys. So you'll understand. Let's go round by round. Okay. So let's start with it. Okay. Let's start with the quiz. Okay. So team one, okay, we'll start with round one first. Just a moment, some technical issue. Okay. Can everyone see my screen? Okay, so yes, let's start with round one. And this is for, so let me explain you round one. So what is round one all about? Okay, every question will, you will get 10 seconds. Okay, once the question is there on your screen with the option, okay, the time starts. Is it clear, guys? Once the question is there on your screen, the time will start. If you give me the right answer, okay, if you give me the right answer, you will get 10 points. But if you don't know the answer, that's fine. The question will pass on to the next team. And the next team, if they answer me right, they will get the points. So in this round, you're not going to get any negative points. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Do you require any clarification? Please ask me the question, guys. Any clarification? Any question?
If we don't answer, then we don't get the point. But if we answer the wrong answer, then we get the negative point, or
no, for this round at least you are not going to get any negative points.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so if you answer, you're going to get 10 points. If you don't know the answer, you're going to get 0. That's it. And it will be given to the next team to, you know, if they know the answer. So team one, are you ready for it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let's start at a count of 3, 2, 1. So Devi, are you ready? I can't hear you.
Yes.
Can you have the buzzer? Okay, perfect. Okay, Smita ma'am, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, let's start with it. Okay, at the count of 3, 2, 1. Okay, team one. Okay, the Constituent of India has adopted the fundamental duty from the Constituent of Russia, America, Britain, Japan.
So America.
No, sir. Wait a sec.
Yeah. Who was that? Yeah. Hello?
Hello.
Yeah, who was sir, that? Yeah.
Sir, we want to go for Russia.
Russia, okay.
Okay, so first of all, that it's time up. And Suraj has answered after that. So so this question will be passed on to team two. Team two, you are not going to get any more time. You need to answer immediately.
Britain.
America.
You need to give me one answer.
America.
America.
America. Okay. Now, I'm really sorry. It's not a right answer. It's Britain. The answer is C, Britain. Okay. Now, let's start with the next question for team one only. Okay. Team one, are you ready? Team one, you need to do it a bit faster. Guys, you can't just, you can take time. And if you have some question, you can discuss with your team. Suraj, if you know the answer, you can discuss with your team. Then you can let me know.
Okay, that discussion is allowed. I was not aware.
No, discussion is allowed. That's totally fine. Okay. At the count of three, two, one. Next question. The constituent was originally written in Hindi, English, and Urdu. Is it true? Mir, it's not for you.
Sir, it is false because the constitution was written in Hindi and English only, not in Urdu.
Okay. Are you sure about that?
Sir, this statement is false because constitution was written in Hindi and English. So the statement is false. Yes, sir. I am 100% sure.
Okay. Let me check. Okay. Perfect. Bango. Yeah. Yes. It's a right answer. So you would be getting 10 marks for that. Good one. It's a good, really good start. Okay. So now the next questions will be for team two. Team two, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So at the count of 3, 2, 1, your question is in front of you. At present, how many fundamental duties are in Constitution of India?
Sir, just answer showed
up. I know. That was by mistakely done. Okay. So.
D.
Okay, just a moment. Okay, let me see. Check. Is it D? Yes, it's a right answer. D is a right answer. So, just a moment, guys. This thing is really making. Okay. Now, team two, your next yes. question is, in Indian constituent is the second longest of any sovereignty country in the world. Is it true or is it false?
True.
True.
Yes.
Okay. Yes,
sir.
Are you sure about that?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, guys, I'm not going to carry forward this answer because it's a true and false one. So the answer is false. It is the first longest, by the way. Okay, it's not the second longest. It's the first longest constituent in the world. So again, team two gets 10 marks. Okay. Now let's go to team three. Team three, are you ready for your first question?
Pritesh.
Yes. Pritesh.
Yeah. Yeah.
We won't give them marks. Because, you know, that answer came up.
Okay.
Let's not give them marks.
Okay, no problem. So that means for team two, for first
zero.
Round, zero. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So team three, are you ready for this?
Yes.
Okay.
Sir.
So let's have your first question in front of it. Which fundamental right is described as the heart and soul of Indian constituent?
Right.
Come on, fast. You don't have time. Come on.
B.
Okay.
Right to constitutional amendment. Yeah.
Okay. Are you sure about that? Are you sure about that? Okay. So it's not a right. It's not a right answer.
The buzzer also rang before that.
Okay. Devi, I can't hear the buzzer, huh, my dear.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah,
can you hear now?
Abhi, yeah,
okay.
Okay. So I'll pass on the same question to team 4. But you need to answer me immediately, team 4. Do you know the answer?
Sir, A.
It's A. Okay. A. Are you sure about that?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I'm really sorry that the answer is wrong. The answer is C. Right to life. Okay. So now team 3. Second question. Team 3, second question. Are you ready? Team 3, second question. Are you ready, team 3?
Yes.
Okay. Let's go for that. Both version of constituent was handwritten. Both the versions of the constituent was handwritten. Is it true or is it false? Team 3. Team 3, do you know the answer? Okay. No, it's time up. It's time up. It's fine. So let me ask the same question to team 4. Team 4.
True.
Is it true? Are you sure about that? Team 4, are you sure about that?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's see. Yes, it's absolutely right. It is the longest handwritten constituent of any country on earth, by the way. Okay, yes, it's a right answer. So team 4 gets a bonus 10 points. Okay, so team 4, are you ready for your first question?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let's do it in 3, 2, 1. Oh, the fundamental rights has no value without the right to freedom, the right to freedom of religion, right to property, and right to constituent readiness. The fundamental rights has no value without. Is it A? Is it B? Is it C? Is it D?
So it's D.
B.
It's D. Okay. So are you sure about that? So is it D or B? Tell me one thing.
D.
D. Are you sure, Urja?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let me see. Is it D?
Okay.
It's bang on. It's a right answer. Okay, you get 10 points for that. So you have already got 10 points from the previous question and 10 points now. So you have got 20 points. Congratulations. You have one more question. Okay. That is question 2. It took nearly 4 years to write down the constituent. Is it true or false. Is it false? Is it false? Are you sure about this? Are you sure about this? Okay,
yes,
let's
sir.
See. Let's see. Is it false? Yes, bang on. It's a false. So you get additional 10 points for your question 2. Okay. So for this round, team 4 has got 30 marks. Okay, congratulations. Divya, I can't hear you. If you're buzzing, I can't hear you. Yeah?
Okay. Do you want me to just say time up instead of ringing the bell?
Say like that. Say like that. It's perfect. Okay. Now team 5. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so team 5, you should be in pressure now because team 4 has got 30 points. Team 1 has got 10 points. Team 2 has not opened their account. And even team 3 has not opened their account. Okay. So you can have a good opportunity to do lead. Okay. Okay. Now, so question 1. Are you ready for your question 1?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just a moment. Question 1. Okay. Who is the supreme commander of the armed force in India? Is it the Prime Minister? Is it the Commander-in-Chief? Is it the the president, or is it the defense? Minister of Defense.
Minister of Defense.
The Minister of Defense.
Time up.
Shena, I think, okay. Team five. I think that there is lots of disturbance. Are you outside somewhere? So I think you're somewhere outside.
Yes, sir. I'm outside.
Okay, fine. So you said time. You said D, right?
Yes.
Okay. Are you sure about that?
Yes.
Okay, now that's not a right answer. So let me pass this question to team one. Team one.
Sir, it's the president of India.
It's the president of India. Are you sure about it?
Yes, sir, 100%.
Okay, 100%. Let me see how many percent it is true. Okay. Agar ye 100% true nahi hoga, to kya hoga?
Sir, let's see. Hope for the best.
Okay. Hope for the best. Yes, absolutely right answer. Bang on. Okay. Yes, it is the president of India. So please remember, guys, the supreme commander of the armed force in India, it is the president of India.
Sir, can I add something in it?
Yeah, please.
Previously, when Britishers was there, the president of India was known as Viceroy of the that particular region. So after they left, the Viceroy title was changed to President
of India. Perfect. Sir. Very good, Suraj. Thanks a lot for that quick fact. Okay, let's go for question two for team five. Okay, team five, are you ready?
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
So let's start with it. 3, 2, 1. The law governing our Supreme Court and the concept of procedure establishment by the law was adopted from the Constituent of UK. Is it true or false? Is it true or false?
False.
Okay. So, okay, let's see the answer. If it's false. Okay. Are you sure, Keval? How sure are you on this?
Yes, sir. I'm sure.
You're sure? Okay. Let's see. Okay. Bang on. So you people get 10 points for that. Congratulations. Okay. So at the end of round one, Smita ma'am, can you let us know the score, please?
Team four leads.
Ma'am, what is the points?
One second. Yeah. Team 4 leads with 30, then team 1 is 20, and team 5 is 10.
Okay. So
team
now,
2 and 3 yet to open their account.
Okay, now so team 2 and team 3, don't worry. We have another round also. Okay, but as I said to you, the round has to have a twist, right? Need to have some kind of twist, some kind of fun. Okay, so now, so let's look at what are the rules and regulation for round two. Okay, now the rounds is, every question will have 10 seconds. If you give me a right answer, okay, it's going to be plus 10. But if you give me a wrong answer, it's going to be minus 3. And there is no question which will be carry forward. I hope you've understood this concept. I hope I've understood the round two. So over here, you're not going to have, you can't have this pass on of your question. Okay, that's number one. Okay, and the most important thing over here is, if you're going to have a wrong answer, you're going to have minus 3. Any questions you have, anyone? Any questions? Team one, do you have any question? Team two, do you have any question?
No.
Okay. So let me proceed. If you have no, you don't know, if you have no question, let me proceed with it. So team one, are you ready for your first question?
So is there the pass on question?
No, it's not there in this round.
Okay.
So the thing goes like this. The right answer, 10 marks. You don't give me the answer, or if it's a wrong answer, it's going to minus 3. Okay. So let's start with your first question. Team one, your first question is, Supreme Court has the right to free education as the part of which among for the following rights. Supreme Court has made right to free education as the part of which among the following rights. Is it?
Sir, it's right. to life.
Time up.
Okay. It's, so, tell me.
Sir, it's right to life.
Right to life. Right.
Right to life. Option A.
Are you sure about that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, let's check. Or you're going to get -3, huh?
Yeah, sir.
Okay, chalo,
sir, unanswered ka bhi -3 hai na.
Okay, good. Okay, that's a confidence move to get a -3. But it's not a -3, it's +10. Okay, it's a right answer. It's right to life. Okay, bang on. Let's proceed with your next question, which is question 2. Okay, so team 1, are you ready for it? Okay, so let's start with it. At the count of 3, 2, 1, the right to freedom guarantees to the citizen of India 6 fundamental freedoms. True or false?
Sir, it's true.
It's true. Are you sure about that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Absolutely bang on, guys. So you have scored 20 out of 20. Okay, that's a good start. Okay, so now let's go for team 2. Let's see if you can open your account. Okay. Team 2, are you ready for it?
Yes.
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
Okay, let's start with your first question for round 2. Before the independence of India, Dadra and Nagar Haveli were under the administrative control of... Is it British, French, Portuguese, or Afghans?
British.
British. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Are you sure about that?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
So I would really say that it's a wrong answer and it's Portuguese. Okay. So please remember Goa, Daman, Diu, and Dadra Nagar. It's all was under the Portuguese administrative. Okay. So let's go for team 2. Your second question. Okay. Let's start with your second question. Are you ready for that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let's check it. Okay. Who among the following was the first Chief Justice of India? And he resumed his office on 26 Jan 1950.
D.K. Mukherjee.
Okay, let's check. Is it a right answer or a wrong answer? Let me check. It's a wrong answer. It's Harilal. It's C. Okay, so it's a wrong answer. So team 2, unfortunately, you didn't open your account. And both the time, you had a wrong answer, so it's going to be -6 for you guys. Okay, now team 3, are you ready? Suraj, don't add something on lines, please. Okay, team 3, the first question is, under the Constitution Article 9343, which is the official language of the Union? Is it Urdu, Hindi, English, or it's B and C together?
B.
On, are you sure about that?
Hindi.
Is it B? You said Hindi, right?
Yeah.
You said Hindi, right? So that's B.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's check. Is it a right or a wrong answer? I'm sorry for that. It's a wrong answer. Okay. Its official language is both. It's Hindi and English, which is B and C together. So for that, you're going to get -3 points. I'm really sorry for that. So team 3, this is the last question for this round at least. So think for this particular question, which is going to be your second question and the last question. Okay, think about it before answering. Okay, so your second question is, the Constituent of India came into effect on, very simple question.
26 January 1950.
A. Are you sure about that?
26th January 1950.
Let's check. Are you sure if it's the right answer? Yes, it's a right answer. Congratulations, you are getting 10 marks for that. Okay, so now with that, the team third, second question is done. So team four, are you ready for it? Team four, are you ready for it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So at the count of 3, 2, 1, the question is in front of you. Indian Independence Act passed by the British Parliament on. Indian Independence Act passed by British Parliament on. Is it A? Is it B? Is it C? Is it D?
C.
It's C. It's 14 August 1947, right?
Time up.
As you mentioned to me, it's C, right?
Yes, sir.
C. Okay, let me check. Is it the right answer? How sure are you about this answer? If you have to tell me a percentage, 50%, 70%, 100%, what is the percentage line? How sure are you guys? You're not sure at all? Are you sure?
You're just sure.
Okay, let's check. Let's check the answer. It's D. It's 20th July 1946. Okay. So for that, you're getting a -3, a negative mark. But I don't feel so you need to worry about it because you have took a good lead in your first round itself. Okay. Let's go for your second question. Are you ready for your second question? Okay. Last question for you guys for this particular round. So let's check now. In India, when both office of Prime Minister and Vice President, President and Vice President happen to be vacant simultaneously, who will be discharged the duty of the President? Is it A? Is it B? Is it C? Is it D?
D.
Okay. How sure D. are you? How sure are you?
100%.
100%. Okay, 100%. Let's check the answer. Bang on. It's the right answer. D. Okay, so you are getting 10 points for that. Okay, so that's okay. We started with -3, but you concluded with +10. Okay, now it's team five.
Yes, sir.
Are you ready for it? Okay. You need to really think about it, huh? Before you answer, think about it. Okay, I think so there are lots of disturbance around. Shehnaz, are you somewhere out somewhere?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you can keep on mute. It's fine.
Okay.
So, Cable, your
yes.
first question is in front of your screen in 3, 2, 1. Which one is known as lower house? Is it
Lok Sabha? Lok Sabha, 100% sure.
100% sure. Okay, lock kiya jai.
Lock kiya jai.
Okay, perfect. Let me see the answer. Bang on. It's a right answer to 10 marks for you guys. Okay, so start is pretty good. Okay, Keval. Okay, so let's check. Let's see the next one. Okay, are you?
Yes, sir. Ready.
Okay. 1, 2, 3. Next question is, which is one of the following is not a fundamental right?
Right. So wait.
Yeah. You have time. Think about it.
Right to property. Right to property is not a fundamental right. I'm 100% sure.
But don't you feel so right now we are really fighting on properties?
Yes. Property is the main thing from which we get a good amount of income.
Time up.
Okay. Time up. Okay, so let's see if it's a right answer. Or how sure are you, yeah? Keval, how sure are you about this question?
I read, sir. It's not the. Okay. It was not a fundamental right.
Perfect. That's good. You have read it. So let's check now. Yes, it's a right answer. Okay, so you're getting a 10 points for that. Okay, so now the round two ends over here. Okay. And now before we proceed to round three, let's look at the score, because for the round three, only the top three teams will be proceeding for the third and the fourth round. So Smita ma'am, can you let us know which are the top three teams which has proceeded to finals?
Yeah. Team one, is leading with 40.
Okay.
Team 4 with 27.
Mm-hmm.
And team 5 with 30. So okay. These three teams will go to the next round. Team 2 is with minus 6 and team 3 is with 7.
Okay. So team 2 and team 3, thanks a lot for participating. It was a great to have you guys. Okay. It was a good fun, good war, I would say. But, you know, ultimately, only the three teams goes to the final. You can be a part of this quiz. Please be there. Okay. So we will see who is the winner now. Okay. So now what we'll do is, for me, ma'am, can you tell me team 1 is which college?
Team 1 is Ramnarayan Ruya.
Okay.
And team 4 is Manibhen Nanavati.
Okay. And team 3 and is
Bharati Vidyapeeth.
Okay. So for me now, team 1 is Ruya. Okay. Team 2 is Nanavati. And team 3 is Bharatiya Vidyapeeth.
Okay.
Is it clear, guys? So for me, team 1 is Ruya, team 2 is Nanavati, and team 3 is Bharatiya Vidyapeeth. Okay. So let's see now, you know, now you, as you know your score, please write it down. Huh? You know your scores, yes, right? You know your scores? Perfect. Okay. Because the score of your first round and second round will be carried forward to the third round also. Okay.
Sir, I have one confusion.
Yeah, please.
Sir, in first round, our score was 30.
Yeah.
Correct. And then in second round, we said one
minus
answer
three.
Was wrong.
Yeah, 27.
And that was minus 3, which comes to 27.
Yeah.
And then we said one answer, which was correct. And when and then we got
yes,
10
yes,
plus,
yes.
Right?
Yeah, that's 37. Yes, ma'am.
37.
Okay, okay. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. So let's ma'am, can you just let us know the score again, ma'am?
Yeah, okay. So it's team 1 Ruya 40,
okay.
Team 2 is Nanavati with 37,
okay.
And team 3 which is Bharat Vidyapeeth at 30.
Okay. So we are at a very good start. 40, 37 and 30. Okay? So let's start with the third round. Okay? Are you ready for the third round? Team 1, Ruya College, are you ready for the third round?
Yes,
so before
sir.
We go with the third round, let's check the rules and regulation. It has to be excited, right? Okay, we started at minus 3. Let's check it out. Now, what is the consequence about this particular round? Okay. So, if you give me a right answer, for that, you're going to get 20 points. But if you're going to give me a wrong answer or you don't answer, it's going to be minus 10. Okay. So now I think so you people are very smart. Nowadays kids are very smart. I think so Archie was already starting calculating also. Okay, if two answers are wrong, then you know, all this thing, nothing like that. Okay. Okay. So let's start with it. Team 1, are you ready? Suraj, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, perfect. Let's start with it. Devi, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, let's start with the first question of third round. Okay, let's take it a bit seriously. Okay, the president can't dash Lok Sabha. Is it A? Is it B? Is it C? Is it D? The president can't dash Lok Sabha. Come on, guys, fast.
Time up.
Okay, now let's take a guesswork. Okay. Okay. If you had to answer. Okay, if you have to answer, kya reh sakta?
I guess
sir. Okay, what's your answer, Archie?
I think B.
Oh, sir, my answer was dissolve.
Dissolved. That's A, right? You know, if you would have gone with A, that was a wrong answer. But if I would have gone with B, Archie was the right answer, by the way.
Okay. So it means if we don't answer within 15 seconds, we get zero, even if we give right answer after 50 seconds.
No. So the thing is, Suraj, you have 10 seconds to answer my question. Okay. Give me a right answer, you get 20 points. If you don't give an answer, or even if you give me a wrong answer, it's going to be minus 10. So in this scenario, you guys got minus 10. Okay. Now, don't worry about that. There's another question also. Okay, there's another question also. Don't worry about it. So let's, with 3, 2, 1, the question is in front of you. When fundamental duties were added in the Constituent of India? When fundamental duties were added in the Constituent of India?
Sir, it's 1976.
So that means A, right?
Yeah.
Perfect. Are you sure about that?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's check. How sure are you? Okay. Bang on. It's a right answer. You're getting 20 points for that. Okay. So a good start. Okay. So there's another question also. So there are three questions in this round, by the way. Okay. So are you ready for your next question?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's start with your next question over here. Which of the following is not the fundamental duty? Which of the following is not the fundamental
duty? Option B. Obey the parents.
Are you sure? Yeah, come on. We have to obey. That is rights, right? That's a duty, right? How can you say like that?
Time up. That is a duty of a human being. But as a citizen of India, it is not a duty.
So that means you want to say openly that you don't want to obey your parents. Huh?
But that is a moral duty of a person, but that is not the fundamental duty of the person being a citizen of India.
Okay, so let's check down the answer now. Okay, is it a right answer or wrong answer? Bang on, it's a right answer. So you're getting 20 points for that. Okay, so again, a good start for this round. Okay, now let's go for team two. So that's Nanavati. Team two, are you ready for that?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's start with a count of 3, 2, 1. All the speeches made in the House of People are addressed to. All the speeches made in the House of People are addressed to. Is it A? Is it B? Is it C? Is it D? Come on, guys. You can say it.
Speaker of Parliament.
Guys, you need to answer before 10 seconds. Okay, so for me, it is an unanswered question. Okay, so let's look at the answer. Okay, if you had to give a guesswork, it would be? What would be the answer?
B,
the speaker. Are you sure about that? Or you were okay, guess it's like more like a guesswork. Is that guesswork or you're sure? Okay, guesswork. Okay, let me check. Okay, we are following the footstep of team one. Huh? Yes, it was a right answer. Guys, please, you need to buckle up. You need to be faster. You need to answer me faster, guys. You can't just think about it. You only have 10 seconds. Huh? So now for that, you're getting minus 10. Okay. Let's go for the next question. And you have enough time. So you have more two questions to go. So you have more time for that. Let's go for the next question. Are you ready for next question? Are you ready for the next question? Okay, let's look at the next question. Which of the following is not a fundamental right in the Constituent of India? Which of the following is not a fundamental right in the Constituent of India? Which one? Fast.
A.
Right to work. Okay?
Yes.
Okay. Let me check it out. The answer, if it's a right answer. Okay. Bang on, it's a right answer. So, yes, we are following team one. Good one, by the way, team two. Okay. So, let's look at your next question. Okay. So this is the last and final question for this round, round three. Okay. Are you ready? At the count of 3, 2, 1, Indian citizenship can be acquired by birth, by naturalization, all of the above. Come on, guys, fast. A, by birth.
Yeah. Time up.
Okay, so I got the answer, which is A, okay, which is by birth. Okay, Urja, why do you feel so by birth only I can become an Indian? Any reason behind that? Yeah, I'm born and I'm Indian. So any reason behind that?
No, sir.
Okay, so actually the answer is, it's all of the above. So you can become a citizen of India by all of three options which you have over there. It's not necessary that it will be by birth only. Okay. Let's go for team three now.
Yes, sir. Sir, okay. We are having for this one 15 minutes, right?
No.
15 seconds, sorry.
Yeah.
15 seconds.
Okay. So now you have a good chance now. Okay, guys, you have a good chance. Now, let's go for...
Sir, I had a doubt.
Please tell me.
Sir, we have 15 seconds for this round, right? For question 15 seconds. Okay. Thank you.
Okay, let's start with it.
Yes.
Which of the following is not a feature of the constituent of India? Which is of the following not a feature?
Sir, D, it is presidential.
Okay. Are you sure about that?
Yes, I'm 100% sure about that.
Okay, let's not follow team one. Okay, let me check. Time up. Okay, let me check. Yes, it's a bang on answer. Good one. Okay, so you have got 20 points for that. Okay, let's go for the next question, which is question two.
Yes.
The right to vote can be placed in which among the following category?
It's the fundamental right, sir. Fundamental right, I'm sure with the answer. Fundamental right.
Fundamental right. Okay. So let's check the answer. Okay, if it's a right or a wrong answer. I'm really sorry. It's a wrong answer. It's a legal right. Okay, so you're getting minus 10 for that. Okay. Don't worry. You have one more question for the round three. Okay. Are you
ready, sir?
Are you ready? Okay, let's do it at the round 3, 2, 1. Okay, who is the head of the government in India? Is it A? Is it B? Is it C? Is it D?
It is A, the president. 100% sure.
100% sure. Okay, let's check about it. Bang on, it's a right answer. Okay. I think so. Things have changed a bit now after this round, after third round. Okay, Smita ma'am, can you let us know what is the score now?
Yeah, just a second. Huh?
Yeah.
So, at the end of round three, we have team one leading with 70. Team two is at 37.
Okay.
And team three is 60.
60. Okay. Chalo, good start. Okay. So so team one is 70. Team two, you are 37. And team three, you are 60. Okay. So team three, you are only 10 points away from Ruya. But you know, it's not the end. Now the final countdown has started now. Now the real thing is, it's now, you know, the real surprise is now, okay, which is round four. Okay, this will change everything now. Okay, let's check now. Okay, what is round four? So round four is, the right answer will get you 40 points. The wrong answer will get you minus 20. And the most important thing, this is a buzzer round. So,
buzzer.
I'll let you know. So when we say buzzer round, there are three questions over here. Okay. So this three questions is open for all three teams.
Okay.
The person who raised their thumb first. Okay, which you have it in your smiley, by the way. Can you show me thumbs? All three teams can show you. Only one of them. Okay, perfect. Yes, Archie. Keval, can you show me thumb? Like what team one is showing me? It's in smiley. There is smiley over there. Okay, let me tell you exactly. Okay, perfect. Team two, sorry, okay, perfect. So you have understood, right? Okay. Are you ready? Okay, so now I'm clear. It's very clear. This question is open for all three. So myself. So now who's going to do the thumbs up is in my screen, I can only see three people. Okay, I'll be very frank with that. I can see Archie, I can see Keval, and I can see Urja. So I'm expecting the thumbs up only from these three people only. This is very clear.
Sir, can't you see?
No, I can't. Okay, the thing is, Suraj, for me, if I have to see you, then I can't see team. So please try to understand the arrangement of Zoom is not like that. I can see everyone.
Pritesh, I can see all.
So
if you want me to help, I can.
Oh yeah, you can see all. Perfect. So let's do it that way. Okay. So Divya would be the person. Suraj, okay. Urja, can you talk?
Urja, yes.
Can you talk? Okay, perfect. So I can see now. Okay. So Divya would be the judge. Divya, decision is a final decision. We are not going to have any argument on that, guys. Is it clear, guys? We are not going to have any argument. Divya is the third umpire. And her decision is the last decision for me. Okay? So, Divya, you need to be very, very clear about it. Okay? Okay, let's start. Okay? The first question for the buzzer round will be on your screen. So now let's do like this. The question will be there on the screen. Okay? If you know the answer, even before I can read it, you do thumbs up. Okay, let me give you an example. Okay, let me give you an example. So I'll read one of the question which is already there. Okay, one of the question which is already there. Okay, so you think about it, it's question one, and let's react how it exactly. Okay, Indian citizenship can be acquired by. Okay, so Keval. Yeah, Keval was the first person to do thumbs up. But I'm not going to read the question. The question would be there on your screen. Huh? Okay, so let's start with... Yeah.
Can we both, like, either me or Shazin, can either of us...
I have no problem with that. Okay. Because, Keval, for me, I can only see six people.
Okay.
In my screen, I can only see six people. But Divya can see everyone. So let Divya be the judge for that. So that's why, as I mentioned to you, Divya would be the third umpire. Okay, let's do that at the count of 3, 2, 1. The first question is there in front of your screen is, in the Indian flag, which color? Okay.
Okay, Keval.
Keval. Keval, what is the answer?
Navy blue.
Navy blue.
Sure. Okay.
Are you sure about that? It's a very, very, sure. It's a very simple sure. question. Okay, let's look at it. Yes, bang on. You have got 40 points for that. But other teams, you don't have to worry about that. In this round, you have more two questions to go. So anything can change. This battle can change anyhow. Okay. Now, let's go for the next question. Are you ready? Okay. At the count of 3, 2, 1, and the question is, who was the chairman of the draft committee of Constituent Assembly?
Keval again.
Ma'am, I also did it.
So, Archie.
Ma'am, me also.
I was the first one. I can see everyone here.
Guys, I have already told you.
Hold on.
The one that I see on my screen first will be first. So it was Keval's thumbs up that came up first.
I saw after me, the other one came up. After I did 2 seconds after.
Keval, I don't want to argue on this. I had made it very clear. Devya would be the third umpire. For me.
Yes, sir. Okay.
So tell me the answer fast.
Dr. B. R. Ambedkar, option A.
Option A. Okay, let's check it out. Yes, it's a right answer. Okay, let's go for the third question. Okay, at the count of 3, 2, 1, the term of member of Rajya Sabha is
Keval again.
Keval, what's the answer?
It's 6 years.
6 years. Are you sure about that?
I am 100% sure about this answer.
Okay. That's the right answer. So we have the winners. Okay. So congratulations, Bharatiya Vidyapeeth, for winning this competition. Okay. It was such a good one. Okay. So guys, I had made it very clear because when it comes to buzzer round, it has to be there. We had played a few examples also. So no hard feelings in this. Okay. Meeta ma'am, can we have the winners, please?
Yeah. Team 3, which is Bharati Vidyapeeth, is really leading with, has won with 180 points.
Wow. Okay.
The second team, second team is Ramnarayan Ruya with 70. Okay. And
Team 3 is Nanavati.
Team 2, that's Nanavati, stands third with 37.
Awesome. Okay, guys.
So we had a very good, I'm sure we all had fun. Yeah, I'm sure you guys had fun.
Sir.
There was a lot of learning also in this.
Amazing.
Okay. So we come to a close of our event. I request Malti ma'am, are you there or?
Yes, I'm there, and I thank all the participants, all the students who have participated at such a short notice for this event. We really had a good time. You know, it's a very serious subject, and we would like to thank our quiz master who did a very excellent job in this. I thank Advan Knowledge Hub also for putting this for us together today, and I congratulate all the winners and thank you for participating. And Smita, thanks for doing this event for us today. So take our leave.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Bye. Yes. Bye-bye.
Okay, guys. Thanks a lot, guys. Have a good day, guys. And thanks for participating, guys. Thanks a lot.